Hello friends, this is Yogesh Gupta and in this video I'll be teaching you basically how to install DC++ as well as how to configure the router to port forward the information to DC++ software. So let's get started. So first of all we'll need to go to our router. For those who don't know, the router address is the default gateway. So since I'm using my wireless LAN and the default gateway for it is 192.168.1.1, so this is the address of my router and I'll go there. Once I'm there, I'll go to admin and login. Now once in the router, as you can see, the name of the company make of my router is Zyxel and its version is P660HWT1V3. So there I'll go to the network and go to the NAT. In there I'll go to the port forwarding and I'll select the service as user defined. Now I'll activate the service and give the service a name, that is DC++. Sorry, now we'll give it start port, that is 2855, and end port would be the same, 2855, and we'll give the server IP address, that is our machine which is running the DC++, its IP will need to give it to the router, and yeah, our IP is 192.168.1.33, so that will be our server IP here. Sorry. Now once we are done with that, click on apply, and as you can see, it has been successfully configured, and then we'll go to the advanced and user plug and play option. Then I'll activate the following services and I'll click on apply. Now once we are done with this, we can now configure our DC++ software. So I'll first of all install the software. And it's being installed right now. And I'll select the language as English. Install the 32-bit version and click on next. And I'll install the software in the following folder. As you can see, the setup was successfully completed. I'll close the software and run the software once again. As you can see, it's by default taking our host name as the nickname, which is okay for us. Now I'll go to the manual configuration and I'll uncheck the let DC++ determine the best connectivity settings. I'll click on active mode as I have configured my router. Now we'll need to add our IP, that is external IP. Then this IP is here. For your information, if you don't know what is your external IP, then I suggest you go to what's my IP and it will represent your public IP for you. So once it's done, you will need to add the transfer port, which is the same port that you specified in the router, that is 2855, and encrypted port would be something 3645 and the search port would be 4429. And once you are done with this, click on OK. And I'll suggest you restart the DC++ software for a proper startup. Just a moment. Now once again open DC++, and you can see that there are many hubs available, public hubs. So I suggest to test, go to any hub and I'll go here, and we can see the shares of the people. So I'll pick up any random, as this one seems good. Sorry. And as you can see, I have access to the drive of the user. And to check whether we can install, I'll show you a demo. And I'll just get a single thing downloaded. That is. And as you can see, I'm successfully able to download. So that's all for my tutorial, guys. If this video has helped you, please subscribe to my channel, and in case if you have any doubts or comments, please feel free to post it in the comment section below, and I'll be glad to help you. Thank you, guys.